Bienvenidos a Spanish Gurus. Hi everyone. Hola a todos. My name is Maider and in today's lesson we are going to learn how to ask questions in Spanish. Why? Because it's very useful. When? Right now? How? You need to follow me to discover that. Perfecto. Well, in Spanish, as in English and probably in your language, we have some interrogative pronouns that we use when asking questions. So we are going to take a look at these pronouns one by one to understand their meanings, and we are going to learn how they should be used. ¿De acuerdo? Then, empezamos ahora mismo. ¿Qué? What? ¿Qué? Por ejemplo, ¿qué quieres? Quiero café. What do you want? I want coffee. So, when we use ¿qué?, we expect the answer to refer to a thing. ¿Qué? What? Muy bien. ¿Quién? ¿O quién es? Who? Por ejemplo, ¿quién es ese chico? ¿Quién es ese chico? Ese chico es mi amigo. Who is that boy? That boy is my friend. So, when we use quién, we expect the answer to refer to a person. ¿Quién? Muy bien. ¿Dónde? Where? Por ejemplo, ¿dónde vives? Vivo en Bilbao. Where do you live? I live in Bilbao. So, when we use ¿dónde?, we expect the answer to refer to a place. Bilbao is a place. Bilbao is a city. Bilbao is a beautiful city. It's almost the best city in the world. Almost. Muy bien, I'm joking. ¿Cómo? How? ¿Cómo? Por ejemplo, ¿cómo vas a trabajar? Voy en bus. How do you go to work? I go by bus. So, when we use ¿cómo?, we expect the answer to refer to a way. I go by bus, that's the way I used to go to work. Muy bien, continuamos. ¿Cuándo? When? ¿Cuándo? Por ejemplo, ¿cuándo es tu cumpleaños? Es el 2 de julio. When is your birthday? My birthday is the 2nd July. So, when we use ¿cuándo?, we expect the answer to refer to a date. 2 de julio. 4 de noviembre. 1 de enero. A date. Muy bien. ¿Cuánto? ¿Cuántos? How much or how many? Por ejemplo, ¿cuántos hermanos tienes? Tengo 3 hermanos. How many brothers do you have? I have 3 brothers. So, when we use ¿cuánto?, we expect the answer to refer to a number. 3 hermanos, ¿sí? Muy bien. ¿Cuál o cuáles? Which. Por ejemplo, ¿cuál es tu color favorito? Mi color favorito es el azul. What's your favorite color? My favorite color is blue. So, when we use ¿cuál?, we expect the answer to refer to something within a group type. In this case, between all the colors, which one is your favorite? Well, sometimes it's a little hard to understand the differences between ¿cuál?, ¿cuáles?, and ¿qué?, especially because the literal translation doesn't work. But we will speak about that in another video, so right now, don't think about that. ¿De acuerdo? Bueno. The last one. La última pregunta. ¿Por qué? Why? ¿Por qué? Por ejemplo, ¿por qué aprendes español? Porque me gusta. Why do you learn Spanish? Because I like it. So, when we use por qué, we expect the answer to refer to an explanation. And here, be careful, because we have two different forms of por qué. The form that we use in the question, por qué, two words, and the form that we use in the answer, porque me gusta. Porque me gusta. Just one word. Muy bien. And now I think that you are ready to be a detective. Elemental, mi querido Watson. Elementary, my dear Watson. But remember that there are other kinds of questions where you don't need to use the interrogative pronouns. Por ejemplo, for example, when I ask, ¿tienes frío? Are you cold? ¿Tienes frío? Or when I say, ¿can you hear me? ¿Puedes oírme? ¿Puedes oírme? Or when I ask, ¿hablas español? Do you speak Spanish? ¿Hablas español? So, just remember that. Oh, and now, I have a confession. Tengo una confesión. Because as a language student, I know that sometimes the main problem is actually the answer. When you find yourself in a situation where you ask your question perfectly, for example, you think, where is the bank? And you ask, ¿dónde está el banco? And then you feel proud of yourself because the person has understood and is about to answer. So there you are, close to heaven, and oh, el banco está muy cerca de aquí. Sigues todo recto, giras en la primera esquina de la derecha. Cuando encuentras la farmacia, cruzas una vez más, giras a la izquierda, sigues recto y allí mismo está el banco. And that is when you realize that you don't need a bank at all. But it's okay, don't worry, that's a good start. So, go and try yourself and don't be scared. No tengas miedo y buena suerte. Good luck. And remember that you can find a lot of resources to learn Spanish wherever you are in our website, www.spanishgurus.com, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our blog to keep yourself updated with more videos, classes, events, and many other useful and fun sources. See you soon. Nos vemos pronto. Hasta luego. Bye.